Okay. Y'all know families are very important. We gotta love our families. Because what? What? Y'all know I have a brother that's handicapped. I don't care. I'll talk about anybody. Let me tell you something. And don't you dare feel sorry for him. Don't you dare. My brother is the meanest handicap that God has ever created. And he looked like this every day. And he'll just sit in the front yard looking at cars all day long. He screamed at me like that one day. I was like, man, what's wrong with you? That's his favorite word. Okay, I'm telling you right now, buckle up, buckle up. I'm about to tell you the story about Rodney. One day I came home. Rodney was waiting on me in the living room. I don't know why he was always waiting on me. You know the carports where you can pull up and see that big old picture frame window? He in the window like this. And I'm like, damn, what is wrong with him today? And I knew he was going to the front door because he just disappeared out the window, right? So I go to the front door. I open the door. He was right there. I'm like, what's wrong? What's wrong? He me hungry. I said, why you gonna ask mama to get you something to eat? Man, what the motherfucker mama get you? Eat motherfucker, you give me don't eat motherfucker. So I said, okay, calm down, calm down. I'll get you something to eat. I said, you want some McDonald's? No, me want Burger King. So I took him to Burger King. Now I thought because he was handicapped, I could park in the handicapped parking lane. That wasn't true. I get out walking on normal. This dude blocked my car in, so I couldn't go anywhere. I swear to God, he rolled down his window. His head was about this big. He started looking at me. I said, wow, I think I got his spot. My brother Roddy, So then he started talking,
hey, you not helping Parker right there.
I like, man, who are you talking to?
Oh, yeah. You not helping Parker right there.
And the dude spit at me. Why did Rodney get out the car? You're Rodney! Wait a minute. The dude got out of his car. What do you want to do? What do you want to do? They was about to have a handicap fight. They started swinging, but they wasn't hitting nothing. So I had to push them closer together. I told y'all to buckle up. Okay. I got to tell you this, though. I gotta tell you this, Rodney whooped his ass. We driving down the street, Rodney got his head out the window. Beeloo, beeloo. I like, Rodney, get in here, what's wrong with you? He called ambulance. Beat that motherfucker ass. So Rodney went home. My mama like, what happened to Rodney? Because he had a little torn shirt. He like, beeloo, beeloo. Keep that car ambulance. Keep that motherfucker ass. Y'all think I'm lying. Rodney went in his room. Got out his Rocky Balboa championship boxing belt, put that bitch on, came out in the living room, no, me a champion, no. I will tell you this, we got in trouble with Rodney 2 days later because we caught my parents doing the nasty. I'm serious. We caught my daddy and my mom doing it. They left the door open. My daddy was in that room killing my mama. I mean, he was hitting it so hard. I'm like, damn, mama, fight back. And my daddy's a 2-time Vietnam vet. And for some reason, he can't let go. He's a drill team sergeant. You can hear him behind the door. Hi-yo, hi-yo, hell. Hey, hi-yo, 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 hell. And he did a move I had never heard before. Like, hi-yo. I'm like, what was that? So Rodney started walking around the house. I like, man, shut up. You're going to get us killed, man. So my daddy came out of the room. Who making that damn noise? And Rodney had, so my daddy beating me. Because he thought I put Rodney up to it, which I didn't. Shaq, I didn't. But he wanted Rodney so bad because Rodney wouldn't shut up. He's like, Rodney, come in. No! He beat Rodney across his back with a belt so hard it knocked a sound out of him. When you can hit somebody so hard, you put them on mute. Rodney turned around and slow motion about here. Ow. Y'all think that was funny? Rodney tried to call the police on my daddy. Let me tell you what he did. He took the phone, went into the closet like nobody was going to know he was in there. You could see the phone cord sticking out. But you had to hear the conversation between Rodney and the police department.
911.
Excuse me? Sir, we can't understand you. Sir, could you please slow down? Okay. Get off your head. Get up. This is the last thing. Then I'm gonna start the show. See, this is why families are so important. Now, I don't know about white people, but I know everybody black and Latino got an uncle somewhere down the line in their family that dressed just like this, nipples right to the belt loop, and got that one little testicle to hang on the side. And my Uncle Charlie, one, you ever notice when cats get old, they start leaving that one arm behind and they be looking for their steps like that. There it is. And my Uncle Charlie, you ever notice your old school cats think they created dancing? I gotta tell you this. I had my go to my family reunion a couple years ago and my Uncle Charlie was in the kitchen cooking fish. And when all my aunties are in the living room dancing, you know when you ladies get drunk, y'all all do the same dance, right? So my auntie like, come on girl. Yes, right, turn it up. Now I gotta show you my Uncle Charlie. My Uncle Charlie heard this song, came out and lost his living mind. He like, God damn, what's going on out here? Ah, there it is, boy. Ah, there it is, nigga. He said, you don't know nothing about Charlie. Back it up, Charlie. Moonwalk, Charlie. He said, you don't know nothing about Charlie. Then he did a dance move I had never seen. He said, here we go now. My name is Ernest. I love y'all so much.